Your gut microbiome, has an appetite for whatever you're feeding it, and that probably influences profoundly your own appetite. So I think if you have sugar-eating gut microbes, you're probably going to be craving sugar if you go, a few hours without having sugar.
Yes,
Because,
there's.
and I think I would be very interested in not only like shifting someone from a high carb diet to two or three different types of ketogenic diets, I think would be
Yeah.
important with specific fatty acid compositions and fiber compositions. And I think it's the diversity of the fiber that's incorporated. But
Diversity, yes, it is very important. There have been, there's lots of different types of bacteria, and they're eating different precursors to generate a lot of these other signaling molecules, short-chain fatty acids and things like that, that are regulating your immune system. They're regulating, literally hematopoiesis, Tregs, natural killer cells, lots of, and this is a whole blooming field of research. That's also another reason I've been a little hesitant to experiment with this because fiber is so important to me. Fiber from vegetables, I'm not adverse to fiber from fruits, so fiber from fruits. Legumes, beans, I like to get a lot of fiber in my diet, and so I don't know if that is that compatible with
I
a
get more
ketogenic.
fiber on a ketogenic diet, and we're talking about a well-formulated ketogenic diet,
Yeah.
as Jeff Volek likes to, and because that is really important, because you talk to people that eat ketogenic diets and it's all over the board. But I
Yeah.
think a well-formulated ketogenic diet would have an abundance of fiber sources from everything from green vegetables, of course, but would include a salad. And I think it's really important from a gut microbiome perspective to get in raw vegetables. I think from what I've known and the half dozen individuals that I talked to that are kind of experts in this field, they think that that has a pretty profound effect. And I've always done that, and I would say my gut health has not, it may have maybe due to what I eliminated in my diet. I grew up in an
Right.
Italian family eating a lot of pasta breads, so they were the staple foods. And I gravitated toward a paleo diet mid-90s, early 2000s, and then the ketogenic diet. And I have never had better gut health than when on a ketogenic diet. But my diet is, like I said, more of a modified Atkins and has a pretty liberal amount of vegetables in it. And I think the benefit to including the vegetables, they're just carriers for the fat. And they also slow protein digestion, which helps minimize the insulin spike that you can get from protein and helps keep me in ketosis.